My name is Miles Glynn. I'm a mixed media artist. I live and work in Bozeman, Montana. I was driving and delivering artwork to Texas, and I decided to go out of my way and take a detour to Marfa, Texas. As I was there, I learned about this movie having been filmed there. And at the time, I was just also starting to work with more figurative Western figures and kind of highlighting the personalities of Western figures. But at that point, I was only working with more anonymous figures, so people from old advertisements or old illustrations, things like that. These images that came from this movie, it just made sense to kind of take the path at that point into celebrities. So this movie in particular stars Rock Hudson, Elizabeth Taylor, and James Dean. So each of these has between one or two, at the most three elements within them. So these, for instance, have gold leafing and acrylic paint, and it's a silkscreen ink that's applied on top of them. Music is probably my greatest source of inspiration. I feel like I constantly am trying to create visually images that are as good as the music that I hear and the music that tends to resonate with me. And interesting, I just heard an artist who I really like not too long ago in an interview. He said that the exact opposite. He said when he writes a song, he begins with an image in his mind, and he's working toward sonically creating something that fits the image that he has in mind. So that resonated with me, because it's the exact opposite for me, where music is just a constant soundtrack to my life, both professionally and personally. And so music's a huge influence. I come from a background where my father was a photojournalist in the Army for 20-something years, 22, 23 years. Having tagged along with him on photo assignments and working with him in the dark room, and just informally kind of absorbing that sensibility for images telling a story, or images prompting people to want to learn more about a story. I mean, that was his world, that was his life, was capturing images that would support a story and make people want to read that article. Or pick up that newspapers. Yeah, I mean, art, it means a lot of things. I would say the thing that I appreciate most about it is that it doesn't need to exist. You know, we go through this whole entire world of art is set up, and there's so many factors, so many hours, countless hours, literally, of artists putting in time, creating imagery that doesn't have to exist. It's only made for enjoyment or to provoke feelings, but it doesn't have to. You know, we need automobiles, we need airplanes, we need utensils. There's things we need in this world that people put a ton of time and effort into making. Art doesn't have to be here, but we choose to. And so I'm really drawn by that aspect, that that it's something that we do purely for enjoyment. The folks here at Prospect Gallery, which is also part of Park City Fine Art, they're fantastic at communicating with people. They have, you know, whether it's social media, whether it's direct contact, they're just fantastic people to work with. So I would encourage anyone to contact Park City Fine Art and get the ball rolling in terms of seeing imagery or asking questions, that kind of thing. I have my work throughout the West at five different galleries. But this is the only gallery where I'm showing this body of work, of Giant's work. At Miles Glynn Art is my Instagram. I don't use any other platform, but definitely put plenty of posts up on the Instagram. So I have a daughter who's 8, who happens to be really creative herself. I would say to any young artist, I would just encourage free play. There's so much to be gained, both in the moment of just enjoying the process of making artwork, but there's also, in terms of development, so much to be gained as well through just not deliberate, but just casual free play. Whenever something strikes you, you know, pick up your favorite medium, whether it's a pencil or a brush, and use whatever you have around, paper, old cardboard, anything. Like, I would say just follow your instincts and have fun with it, and don't let anything hold you back. You know, don't worry about what materials you have or don't have. Don't worry about what anyone thinks of it, whether someone's going to see it or not see it. I would say just follow your instincts and have fun playing and enjoying that process. And I think most artists, even professional artists, would say that probably their favorite times are when they get into that play mode, when they're able to just experiment and play and have fun with it.